Sports and Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Brought to you by Molson Canadian, what beer's all about. By Ford of Canada, where quality is more than a commitment, quality is job one. By Pepsi, the choice of a new generation. By Esso retailers and agents across Canada.
Please do not adjust your set. It's just the suit. The vertical's okay. The Bruins are horizontal, and you did predict Boston, and it's a little early, I suppose, to go after you, but 6-0. What's your reaction?
Can I say something about this? You don't say anything when I predict St. Louis. You don't say anything...
I haven't had a chance yet.
Detroit, right, Washington, Montreal, Pittsburgh, Edmonton. Told you Vancouver was going to do a number on Calgary.
But you said Calgary would win.
Oh, they'll win. There you're doing it again. You said 43 points. And Schnapps, is he beautiful or what? I'll tell you, I heard Butcher played a great game, too.
Well, the question was about Boston.
All right, I got to get to Boston. You know I did it with my heart. I would never against Boston. But let's just go over your friend, who he has dinner with and stuff like that, Reggie Lemelin. He has 6 shots on him, and he lets in 3 goals. And that's the problem. They had 2 5-minute majors. That's what killed them right off the bat. Don't count out the Bruins yet.
I know you're doing it because
they can't win at home.
He's my friend, but it doesn't become you to kick someone when they're down. The last time they got to the Cup was with you, and they haven't been there since last year, and the only reason they got there was Reggie Lemelin.
All right, then smarten up, Reggie, and get playing again. You know, you can tell when Reggie's in the game. The first shot on net, you can tell, if he's fallen over like that.
Why wouldn't they pull him?
I don't know why.
Because they want to keep Moog for the second in case they do lose. That's probably why.
I'll tell you, Moog will play the rest of the series. I'll bet any dough until he get down on the crunch. What Reggie's got to do is he got to throw him in something that he's been kicked around a little bit, and all of a sudden he come back up again.
In British Columbia, they'll try to make Vernon the provincial capital after last night. Big victory for the Canucks. What happened?
Absolutely. Well, Bob McCammon, as I said last night, he's been playing playoff hockey since October. They got the big centerman, Trevor Linden. Schnapps playing out of his mind everywhere he goes, like he said. Detroit, he's a winner. Minnesota, he's a winner. Vancouver, he's a winner. And how Detroit let him go, I don't know. That's one of the reasons right there.
Will the Flames rebound easily?
Oh, well, they're going to win the series. There's no doubt about that.
Okay, the Oilers and the Kings. 2 goals in the last 3.5 minutes for Edmonton to pull out a 4-3 win.
Well, we were having a few pops last night watching it on TV. Grant Fuhr is, I still say, the greatest goaltender in the world, and he held them in there. Unbelievable. Messier did a job on Gretzky. There's no doubt about that. And Sather, I saw him, you could see him rather shaking hands after. He had a smile here to here. This is hate, folks. In this series, it's hate, and it's a great series.
And you're going there for 3-4.
You're
leaving me.
Yes, this series match, I'm not saying, that Montreal looks too powerful for them. It's going to be nationwide, and naturally they want the Stars there.
What are you going to wear?
Well, I hate to say it, folks. You're going to see this one again. It's such a nice suit. I've only bought 3 on the road, and I can't get home to change, so I'm going to wear this one again.
You're silly to cheer for Edmonton. You should cheer for Los Angeles.
Oh, yeah.
They're the ones with a tailor.
And listen, good one.
Thank you.
Calgary, I might even drop in on the way to see all my friends
in
Calgary.
Well, dress warm if you go there. This is Molson Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup playoffs.
A beer must be clean and cold, and it must have a genuine Canadian taste. Molson Canadian, what beer's all about. Canada's executive class. Convenient, comfortable, almost completely effortless. Some say it's the way business travel was meant to be. Esso Protec Engine Oil brings you this simple demonstration of the effects of friction. 2 objects rubbing together create heat.
When those objects are in your engine, that heat means wear. Deposits build up, fuel economy goes down. Your engine's only protection is a skinned thin layer of oil that either makes it or breaks it. That's fact, not friction.
When I got my real estate license, I thought I knew it all. But you have to keep learning, and you can't do it all alone. So I joined Century 21, and things started to happen. For me and my clients, with over 100,000 agents in North America and abroad, Century 21 has a world of experience. And the industry's finest training program puts that experience to work in my own neighborhood. And that makes a world of difference for my clients. Century 21, the largest real estate organization in the world.
When front-wheel drive was introduced, it promised a lot.
Front-wheel drive?
Front-wheel drive.
But unless you align both your front and rear wheels, front-wheel drive can cause a problem. Increased rear tire wear.
Front-wheel drive.
At Canadian Tire, we specialize in computerized four-wheel alignment that helps restore all the excitement of front-wheel drive.
Trust Canadian Tire, Canada's number one choice for wheel alignments.
Rocky Mountain clear, Rocky Mountain cold, Coors cold gold.
On Street Legal, Carrie's ex returns, but will it last? And an anti-abortionist activities cause a legal controversy.
You took away our chances for babe.
Friday.
Two finals on our scoreboard at Montreal. The Canadiens have a 2-0 lead over the Whalers in the Adams Division semifinal series. 3-2 winners tonight. The Washington Capitals, Philadelphia Flyers, Patrick Division series tied at 1 now. Tim Kerr with the winner for the Flyers in the final minute of regulation time. Let's go back to the broadcast booth and rejoin Bob Cole and Harry Neal.
And before they drop the puck in there, we can tell you that Chicago and Detroit are in overtime. It's tied at 4, and they're on the ice down at the Fabulous Forum in Los Angeles for the start of Game 2 in their series. Edmonton naturally would love to take a 2-0 lead back home. I think L.A., Harry, has to win that game tonight.
I don't think they can beat the Oilers 4 games in 5 nights, 3 of them at Northland.
2-0 here for Calgary. For the goal at the end of the period for the 2-0 lead. Smeal clears it. Bozak gets away from McCrimmon. Lube knocked it across center to McCrimmon and Neuendijk. Neuendijk going in. And he was upended before he could get a shot. Butcher brings it out. Slides a pass up across center. Smeal coming in. Here's a chance for Sutter. And he couldn't handle the pass in front of Vernon. Back to the line. Nordmark. His shot blocked. Flames get it out. Patterson, who had a strong first period defensively, and then got the second goal for the Flames. He's in there for checking. McCown played it back up to him. He didn't see it. Canucks try to get one early. They need one to slow the Flames down. Boy, have they come out tonight. Here's Gilmore, and he was stopped at the side of the net. Then he falls. Tandy gets the pass away. Adams comes up to center and shoots it in. He got away from Merzen. Adams dropped it back for Bridgman. He didn't see it. Down the ice again. Melnick back there. Bridgman sliced it down the other way. It rolls in toward Vernon, so no icing. Kopinski's pass for the middle is a good one. Gilmore shoots it in across the line. Very quickly, and again McLean was sharp. This time it'll be icing with Snips coming back to touch it. Icing against Calgary. We have another update for you. Here's Scott Oak.
Well, Bob, it took Mario Lemieux 5 years to get to the playoffs. Now he has his first ever playoff goal, an empty netter from the blue line against the Rangers. The Penguins are on their way to a 7-4 win and a 2-0 series lead.
Joel Mullen taking a lovely little flip pass from Gilmore and a hard backhand. And as you said, Bob, another great stop by Kirk McLean. He's had more shots than Ben Johnson.
Okay. Boy, he stopped them all, that's for sure. Just about all of them. He didn't have any chance on the two goals. Little weak shot by Linden. Hunter takes it to center with Poplinski. It's dropped back in front of the net, and the Canucks break it up. Sandlack comes back across center. He's in there with Steph Poplinski's shot. Hunter made the save. And Poplinski was back to pick up a loose puck. DeMar Hunter going by Snepps. Snepps chasing Hunter. Pass all the way back to the line. Flurry shot. Kicked away. Might have missed the net on the short side. But McLean didn't take a chance and kicked out the left leg. Linden coming up. Linden stops. Feeds a pass in by the net. Vernon tapped it away. In back of the goal again. And Ramage leaves it for Flurry. Coming out. He's the center, Fleury gathering speed and coming in. Now he turns. Passes in, and he scores! The pass way in front to hit a Vancouver player. I'm not sure McClellan touched it, but McLean didn't even see it. 3-0.
Well, the puck was sitting right under McLean's pat pad. And when he got up or moved, he seemed to drag it in on his own. And the Flames go up 3-0, and the Fleury-McClellan-Hunter line was on for the tire and the winner against them last night, so I'm sure they're delighted to get this one. Now look at that, you see McLean got pushed way back in the net, and it's a possibility that the puck hit Reinhardt in front, but I think Fleury will get credit for it.
Fleury gets the goal at 3:20, and the Flames are off and running here in game two, leading 3-0. They're not going to let up. You know they do not like protecting the lead. They'll keep coming at Vancouver. And the Canucks, on the other hand, are in a dangerous situation of having to open up a little bit. McCown now, he misses. Kremen slapped it into the corner. Roberts goes behind the net, trying to dig it out against Reinhardt. Can't do it. Now he does. Great chance. Boom! Stop by McLean. Was all alone. Awesome attack by Calgary tonight. Puck cleared to center, and the play caller's got fair penalties in behind the play. We'll be back after this message.
Your lawnmower. You spend hundreds of dollars on a machine you hate to use, then treat it that way. But you always expect it to work. If you own a Lawn Boy, it will. Lawn Boy power equipment is legendary for reliability. That means quality that just won't quit. You'll hate to use your Lawn Boy mower for years and years and years.
That chicken.
On the road again. It's about ordinary people doing extraordinary things.
I'd like to do a song.
Thursdays at 7.
Well, although they've got three goals on Kirk McLean, he still makes these kind of saves. I think hit his arm and then hit the crossbar. You have to wonder, Bob, if they get another one, whether Bob McCammon would pull McLean to keep him as rested as possible for game three and get Steve Weeks in there, because the way things are going, it's a shooting gallery with the Flames doing all the shooting.
I'm sure he'll be thinking about that if indeed the Flames score again. 3-0 now. Canucks move it up to center ice. In goes Bozak. Not much room given to him. Merzen stopped him. Gilmore's pass down on. He reaches in. And Melnick was keeping a close watch on Mullins. Melnick slides it ahead. Bozak turning. Sutter moving in on the left wing. He has to hurry with Patterson giving him a shot. It comes out front. Goal! Sneal! Got the backhander and the red light is not on yet. Everybody thought it was in. And in fact, it did not go in.
Well, I thought it was in too. So did Stan Sneal, and I the net, makes the save.
Now Al MacInnis skated right across in front of Bergen, and of course, we lost all view of the puck from that point. MacInnis was between our broadcast point and Vernon, but in behind MacInnis, Vernon obviously was diving down and got his glove there. Now Steele will not believe that puck did go in because, as you said, Harry, when he took the shot, the net was empty.
And all three Canuck forwards jumped with their hands in the air as if they scored.
So it's still 3-0. As close as anybody wants to come to getting the goal. Going to be a tough night for Vancouver if the chances are going to be like that. And he still won't go in. This shot away off the net. Bridgman not coming close. The Flames Ramage is up on this play. Suter trailing. Suter now. And he doesn't shoot it. Ramage dies. Flames stop that easily. Lidster turns to come back now for Vancouver to center. Lidster flipped one in and the Canucks want to make changes. We're told the game is underway in Los Angeles. We'll keep you posted as to when he's scoring. Scott Oak is watching all these games for us. Here's Kopetsky. Coming in, centered it. Hunter was covered in front of the net. Linden picks it up and sweeps away. Linden, the fabulous rookie, in on a shot, low one. Big save, Vernon. McClellan backs up a bit, eludes the check. Linden found it and lost it, and it's clear down. And there's an injured player along the boards.
Jimmy Sandlack was really decked, and he looks like he's in pain here. As the Calgary Flames have been on the right end of most of the body checks tonight, and this one was a bone crusher, and Sandlack was on the wrong end of it. Everyone left zone and Sandlack couldn't get up. Let's have a look at the replay here. Actually, it was Sandlack who tried to throw the check, Bob, and he missed as McClellan stepped out of the way, and it looks like he went into the top layer of the boards there.
I think what happened, you mentioned that ledge. There is a ledge along the boards where the glass meets the boards. And he went right in there face first.
Well, it looks like it might be his knee as he lunged in, missing the attempted check on Brian McClellan. Sandlack is that kind of a body checker. He kind of lunges at you. If he hits you, he's a big boy. If he misses, this is what could happen. Vancouver Canucks, whose depth is not their strength, can't afford to lose a big, strong winger like Jimmy Sandlack.
So they help him up, and he'll go to the Canucks bench.
GT.
That could be. Well, let's have another look at that goal, or we thought it was a goal by Stan Spiel. A miraculous recovery stop by Mike Vernon. We'll show it to you later. There's some question about whether Vernon's glove with the puck in it was in the goal.
McCown drops it back. McCrimmon starts the play for the Flames to center ice. Fleury on the move again. Exciting young hockey player, Thurin Fleury, number 14. Many things happen when he's on there. Got a goal, the third for the Flames tonight, here in the second period. Vernon coming out. We saw Bozak come in. Smeal stopped it in the corner against Fleury. Now Smeal digs it out. Centered it all the way back to the line. The two defensemen cross through the wire. Reinhardt bucking with Butcher, and they had to bring it outside the line. McClellan coming in, and he had two chances. He had the netminder down and missed it. Then he held on to it, looked pretty cool, and then missed. missed on the second chance with a net empty. Brickman is nailed. Smeal, or rather, Tandy took a shot going in, and it's cleared out of the zone and down the ice. Tandy and McCown colliding. McCown lost the helmet. You'll see him in a moment. If the Canucks can move it down the ice, and they're having a tough job with that tonight. Now they've switched around. Merzen is on the ice, and he'll come back to pick it up. So icing called against Vancouver. 3-0 is the score. The Flames are out front.
I've got the surveillance photos here, number 6. This thing is really big. Look.
Vancouver, Toronto, Halifax.
It's everywhere. More than half the Diet Coke drinkers who received taste packs said they prefer the taste of Diet Pepsi.
It's a Diet Pepsi taste drive.
Number 14. Isn't this your wife?
What?
My wife? Change to Diet Pepsi.
McClellan, 27, gets a real chance here on a careless play by Bozak, but he's exhausted and loses the puck, and as you said, Bob, gets a second opportunity, but on a turnaround slap shot. Now, has Vernon got his glove in the net with the puck in it on that miraculous stop on Stan Smeal or not? Only Vernon knows.
I don't know. Our cameraman had a heck of an angle on that, and there's a chance that glove was in over the line, but it was so close.
But the Canucks didn't argue at all, so not many people saw it in black sweaters.
Well, the Canucks see that replay. It'll be a different story. But it's still 3-0. And the Calgary Flames, no question about it, are in complete control of the second game. Now the Smythe Division semifinals, 21-13. The shots on goal. We have 12:32 left in the second period. Otto with a goal tonight. Getting a Nieuwendyk got the draw back. And through center is Linden. Whoa, he came close to putting one in. On the glove side of Vernon, had it moving the other way. And his quick shot surprised the goaltender, but missed the net. Lou going in. Back in. Linden again is trying it. Moved it up. Street call. Tipped away by Vernon. Roberts skated away. Nieuwendyk with him. Roberts in. Fanned on it. Lidstrom covered him. Here's Linden once again coming out with a puck to center. Linden goes over the line. Rocket. Street call. Shot. Tipped away by Vernon. A good reaction by Vernon. And a penalty has been called. Vernon was ready for the first shot. Then it was deflected. He appeared to be off balance, but he made a great recovery.
When it's ready for friends to play, there's a place to cook the day away. Fire it up, get ready, try something new. We're talking King of the Grill for it to barbecue with the Silver Bullet. The right beer now, the right time, the right beer, Coors Light.
The light, bright taste, Coors Light.
Hold on to the silver bullet. It's the right beer now.
At the Miller side tonight, another Calgary penalty. This time it's Merzen for tripping here at 8:20 of the period. Montreal taking a 2-0 lead in their series, defeating Hartford. Boston 5-3. They get back into it over Buffalo. Philadelphia back into it with Washington with a one-goal spread in that game. Pittsburgh 2-0 in their series 7-4. Overtime, we're waiting. Third period, could be overtime coming here. We'll keep you posted. This game is just underway, and we're watching it.
The Calgary Flames have killed off 10 straight power plays in the first game and a half of the first round of the playoffs here, trying to make it 11.
Linden gets it back. Nordmark gets a chance here. Shoots. Way down Vernon. He was in perfect position and just allowed the puck to come to him. And then he smothered it.
Nordmark made a nice play, waiting and waiting to get some black-shirted teammates in front of the net. But no one got there. Vernon saw the whole shot. A Now watch how long it takes any Calgary, any Vancouver forward to get to the front of the net. The Crimmin won't let one, and Vernon makes the save, and had that shot been screened, it might not have been as easy to stop.
Great coverage by the Calgary defenseman, keeping the Canuck forwards outside, allowing Vernon to see it right on. Calgary winning the draw, McCown around the net. He's going to clear it all the way down the ice. Calgary looked to be invincible tonight.
Well, I think the real flame showed up. They were embarrassed last night, and they were well beaten.
Look at Patterson. What a penalty killer he's turned out to be for Calgary. And another great performance again this evening. Now Nordmark coming across center with a pass. Broken up. Back they go again. A minute 20 left on the penalty. Now Nordmark is coming out. To center ice. Recode dumped it in. McCown, the first one back. So he slapped at it. It was stopped though. Squeako on the boards, and Reinhardt in the corner. Tried to set it up at the line. Lidster had to knock it down to keep it in. Linden is tied up. Reinhardt is on it. Reinhardt going to the boards. It's back for the line to Lidster. Lidster flipped it in there again for Linden. McCown, a high one, gets out of his own. 45 seconds left of the penalty. Pass hopped away from Bradley. Goes down the ice, and McCown will take his time naturally. His team shorthanded. Now he plays it out across the line. Butcher a little slow moving on it. Bradley takes it at center. Being watched by Newendyke. All the way back. 25 seconds left for the Vancouver power play. And it's Tandy coming in. Tandy stops, shoots, didn't get through. And Lou will bring it out with Newendyke. The center ice, Lou coming in. Lou gets in there, but won't shoot it. He decides to kill more time. All the way to center and does just that. Now he drops it back to Suter. Penalty is over. The fans love this. Calgary leading 3-0. And killing another penalty. Tandy flips it back. One-sided show so far tonight. Bradley coming in. His pass along the boards. Brinkman is hauled down. And the Calgary Flames go back to pick it up. Fleury's pass. A beauty to McClellan. He's in with Hunter. Tim Hunter fell. And Snuff leads the attack now. He slapped one into the corner. Suter there first. Couldn't clear it, though. Bridgman going back in the net. McGinnis tying him up. Bridgman got loose, and in front of the goal was Suter to give it to McClellan to Tim Hunter. Stopped by Snap. Bozak for Lidster. Lidster's away. A little bit of room, and he just rolled it in as the Canucks want to make changes. 8:45 left to play in period number two. 3-0, Calgary on top of the Vancouver Canucks, who won the first game in overtime last night. Flames want to even the series before it shifts to the Pacific Coliseum. A penalty coming up. Could be against Sutter, and it will be against Sutter. Chance for Mullen, however. He's in, back in front, and the play is called. The Flames had possession. That was a strange whistle, but they had called it. And the penalty will go to Sutter of Vancouver. That big power play of Calgary coming up.
If you're a sports fan, or especially if you're not, don't miss Goodyear's All-Star Tire Sale. You not only save money on tires, you get a specially edited videotape of some of sports' greatest, not-so-great moments. Just buy two or more tires, and this full-length, fun-filled tape is yours at no extra charge. Get in on all the action, from the hilarious to the ridiculous. The Goodyear All-Star Tire Sale. A great deal on tires and a good deal of fun. Sale ends soon at participating Goodyear retailers.
Rich Sutter running in with Brad McCrimmon, and he tries to take his head off when he got his helmet. But for that, he'll get a penalty, and this will be the Calgary Flames' first taste of a power play with 8:16 to go in period two.
What a power play it is. It's been hot all year, and there's no reason to suspect it's going to cool off in the playoffs.
Trevor Linden, who plays on the power play for the Canucks, plays on their top line, kills penalties, turns 19 on Tuesday. I think you have to say anything more about him, do you?
3-0, and they're going for four now. Face-off just inside the Vancouver line. Otto got the draw, but Snepps was on the puck in a hurry to clear it down the ice.
Harold Snepps, who's playing on a leg and a half, gets his first chance to show his specialty, killing the whole penalty off.
Suter brought it in. The Flames are offside on this first attack. A little disorganized hitting the line. Pass slow getting to the line, therefore offside. There's Harold.
What an inspirational performance he put on last night. He killed all the penalties. He blocked two big shots. One with his knee, and I know he's not 100%. He'll play hurt tonight. This is 69th career playoff game.
Limping everywhere today, but playing tonight.
Tough to keep him out of the lineup. He decides it's time to come to the rink.
Suter from center. McGinnis shoots it in. Mullen coming up. Otto with him. Gilmore turning around on the boards. Gets it back to the line to Suter into Mullen again. Mullen stopped by Lidster this time. Now he kicked it loose for Gilmore. Slides it to Suter. McGinnis. McGinnis to Suter. Suter winds up. Shoots.
He runs to the middle right here. Now he's shooting from almost the center. And it might have been tipped a couple of times before it went in the net. But when you can shoot from the middle of the rink at the blue line, it's tough to miss the net.
Gilmore against the goal and hit a pair of sticks. Gilmore was the last.
Great play by Suter to get in position to make that shot.
12:25, the time of the goal. McGinnis and Suter assisting. So Suter the shot off McGinnis. And then off Gilmore. Well, McGinnis gave it to Suter. Hit a Calgary stick in front. Stick in the hands of Gilmore. And what's this from behind the play? Another one. Penalty against Vancouver.
Melnick is going to get a high sticking play, penalty way behind the play. And Vancouver Canucks, the 21st best offensive team in the National League, are in a position where they are least likely to be successful, behind 4-0 with 27 minutes and 19 seconds left in the hockey game.
Melnick high sticking, 12:41, here it is. Exactly where the infraction occurred. A little bit later. However, he's gone for 2 minutes. Gilmore parked in front of the net, getting the power play goal to make it 4-0. As McGinnis passed off the Suter and the shot. Get a Vancouver stick and then Gilmore. And in behind to Kirk McLean, making it 4-0. Another power play now for Calgary. And they're going for 5. Pass into Gilmore, but he's offside. He was breaking all right and behind everybody, but it was tipped at the line.
Well, Gilmore, who has had a great year, but got a infection late in the season and lost, if you can imagine, a guy about 170 pounds losing weight. But he was down into the 150s as he tried to shake a virus of some sort. And I don't think yet that he's back feeling the way he'd like to. But what an addition he's been to this Calgary Flame team. A great defensive center with all kinds of offensive skills.
Joe Lotto now. Flipping it back for McGinnis. He ripped the high one in and hit the back of the net. Snap saw it. Couldn't clear it out by McGinnis though. Gilmore got it back. Mullen waits. Suter is at the line, and he takes it. Now to McGinnis. Back to Suter again.
McGinnis once more. Suter. Pass to Mullen. He'll shoot it. There it is. Really went off to Gilmore like a bullet. Now Suter's shot. McLean has to be very sharp to stop the Flames from scoring again on this power play. Another update for you. Here's Scott Oates.
Bob, in Los Angeles, the same player who opened the scoring last night, did so again tonight. The Kings pressing in the Oilers' zone. Gretzky out front for Chris Kontos. Two swipes at it. The first with a high stick. The second was good. And it's 1-0 Los Angeles over the Oilers midway through the first period.
And in the heat in L.A., they're in another tough game tonight by the looks of the start of this one. Edmonton and Los Angeles.
Temperature 102 Fahrenheit at noon today in L.A. It'd be 302 in the Forum.
And the Flames here are almost as hot. They're leading 4-0 on a power play now. A minute left in the penalty. McGinnis comes to center and ripped it in. Off the boards. Flames everywhere. They're in to pick it up. But Snepps intercepts and he gets it away for Lidstrom. Lidstrom to center. Played it in through the middle. And it was Bridgman knocked down. The play goes on. He's off on a change as Suter comes out to Neuendijk. Neuendijk in. Shot stopped by McLean. And the goaltender holds it as Snepps comes back to protect Kirk McLean.
I always love the way Harold smiles when he gets in the middle of one of these jousts, as if he really enjoys it when it gets a little nasty. That was an easy stop. What McLean had to worry about was Hunter, who was pouring to the front of the net. And you'll see Snepps with a stick on him to make sure Hunter can cause no damage. McLean, who's had 24 shots, Bob, even though it's 4-0, he's the guy who's most responsible for it only being 4-0.
Could have been 8. In the first period especially, the Flames had numerous terrific scoring opportunities. McLean was outstanding. 30 seconds left in the penalty. Neuendijk gets his stick down in front of Bozak. The draw comes all the way back to the Calgary zone. McGinnis turns. McCrimmon is the other defenseman, takes his pass along the boards to let the high one in over Butcher. Snaps back. It's to the line, and now McCrimmon winds up. A rebound is there, and McLean covers that. Hunter again was in front of the net looking for a loose puck. Nearly got one.
Well, the one defenseman for the Vancouver Canucks, other than Snepps, who really sticks his nose in it, is Garth Butcher. I thought he was the best defenseman on the ice last night for both teams. Followed through on almost all his checks, tough in front of the net as he was right then, and moved the puck quite quickly out of his own zone. And I'm sure if you ask the Flame forwards who they least like to play against, if it isn't Big Harold, it's Big Garth.
Flames again line up. They have another 11 seconds left on their power play. Canucks have shut them out a little bit on this one. And it looks as if completely now on this one, with the penalty just about over, as Reinhardt takes over at center in with Smeal. Smeal winds up. Penalty has been served. Calgary leads 4-0. Little over 5 minutes left of the period. Puck kept inside the line by Bradley. And Crimmon has to hustle back. Smeal giving chase. Butcher stopped it at the blue line. Bradley went after Hunter. Took the puck and Hunter got it back from him. And he's in a little bit of trouble in there. The Canucks forechecking. Puck rolling wide of the net. And the play is called. It was a hand pass that was called. And then they want to go at it again. Looked harmless, but then they kept pushing, and I don't think they'll hand out penalties on this one. They get them separated rather quickly. With 4:49 left in the period.
When front-wheel drive was introduced, it promised a lot.
Front-wheel drive? Front-wheel drive.
But unless you align both your front and rear wheels, front-wheel drive can cause a problem. Increased rear tire wear.
Front-wheel drive.
At Canadian Tire, we specialize in computerized four-wheel alignment that helps restore all the excitement of front-wheel drive.
Trust Canadian Tire, Canada's number one choice for wheel alignments.
And Joe Louis Arena, the Chicago Blackhawks, score in overtime. Dwayne Sutter gives them a victory to even the series at 1-1, with it moving back to the Chicago Stadium. Tom Watt, the assistant coach. He wasn't smiling last night, but we caught him smiling tonight, Bob.
They're all smiling tonight, and why shouldn't they be? They're leading 4-0 in complete control. At this point of the second period, the Canucks showing a sign of trying to break through to Mike Vernon and get a goal and get something going, hopefully. Out of the net was McLean, but this time he fired right at the player, and the puck stayed in. Now it's cleared out. Adams pushed it ahead to Bridgman. Adams, though, had gone in as Tandy took the pass, and the Canucks continue to go in there, running into the defensemen who were standing up, and this time they're offside again.
Well, one of the things the Vancouver Canucks have to worry about when they charter home tonight right after the game is what kind of wear and tear these two games have had on them. The first one was not rough like this one's been, and the Canucks have been on the wrong end of most checks. But Calgary is now showing what it's like to play against the big team when the big guys get a little nasty. The Vancouver Canucks are having a difficult time handling the Flames on all the one-on-one battles for the puck.
Fleury on there again with McClellan and Tim Hunter for Calgary. Adams with Tandy and Bridgman as they shoot it in. Shot scramble, they score! Adams gets the goal. They stay with it. And the backhander went in around Vernon. And the Canucks are on the board with 4:04 left in the period.
Well, Vernon was very lucky. He wasn't scored on early in this shift. And here's the goal. Vernon makes the save, but Merson can't handle Adams. You'll see Adams 8 fighting off number 5, Calgary, while he gets the backhand up and over a sprawling Vernon. Dana Merson has to be tougher than that, although Adams is a big, strong boy and tough to take out, and that gives Vancouver a little life, 4-1.
Adams from Tandy and Nordmark at 15:56, 4-1 is the score. Calgary moving up after that scoring play by Vancouver. Newendyke goes in after it to provide some help, gets it out to Suter. Suter, weak shot, kicked away by McLean. Roberts trying to center it. Lube was covered. Newendyke upended behind the net. Nordmark was nailed before he could move by Roberts. Roberts not flying. Puck to Lube. Lube gets it back, and it was tipped away near the blue line. Sutter coming to center. Rich Sutter brings it up to the line and over with Smeal. Sutter going for the net. Can't center it. Bozak went in there. Knocked off to the corner again. Ramage picking it up. To Sutter. Ramage is covering his man. That allows Suter to go around the net. He can't get it out, though. It's knocked down by Lidster. Lidster to Smeal. The Canucks alive now. Center. And finally, Newendyke, relieving the pressure, shoots it down the ice. And in behind the play, there's a penalty called against Bozak of the Vancouver Canucks. Newendyke was upended in behind the play. So there'll be another Calgary power play. They'll be looking for that 4-goal lead.
From Touchstone Pictures, when four crooks from the city try to rob one bank in the country while being chased by two cops from New Jersey.
Give me clothes! Give me clothes!
Things could get a little disorganized.
This is no time to be self-conscious.
It's Corbin Burnson, Reuben Blades, Fred Gwynn, Ed O'Neill, and Lou Diamond Phillips in a comedy about crime.
We got him!
We got him!
We lost him!
We found him!
I'm gonna kill him!
Nothing like working with the best.
Disorganized crime starts Friday, April 14th at a theater near you.
Here he takes a shot from Thomas. The Chippendale Dancers have more clothes on than Nordmark does now. And Steve Bozak gets a penalty right here. And it could have been either Bozak or 15 Sutter. The referee chose Bozak, The Flames will get a power play with 2:44 left in period two. Not a great penalty. Nordbark stressed again. Good for him. He and Reinhardt have taken a combined 11 body checks tonight. Six by this fellow and five by Reinhardt.
So it's 4-1 Calgary, and what a nice way to end a period with the man advantage. Canucks have to be aware of any chance that might open up for them to move down, possibly get a shorthanded goal back. Otto scored one early in the game for Calgary. Kept in by Suter. His shot deflected in front of the net. Mullen takes a look around. Mullen now gets it back to the line of McGinnis to Suter. They'll continue to pass it around on the outside, waiting for someone to get loose in front, and it's Mullen going to the corner, looking back to the line. Mullen has to go the other way. Otto takes it all the way back to McGinnis. McGinnis into Gilmore. Gilmore over on this side for Mullen. Mullen waits. Now to Suter. His shot deflected in front of the net. Scramble for it. And snap for five. And the play is called.
There were two sticks. Two sticks. Two players were in there, Harry, with their sticks underneath, Harold, and they could not budge. Neither the puck nor Harold snapped.
Harold had a hold of big Joel Otto's stick. Joel looked like he was shoveling a big, huge pile of manure out of the barn here when Snap goes down. Watch this. Snap falls on it. Now watch Joel. One, two. Boy, that's heavy. And in comes Doug Lidster to throw Otto off Harold Snap's.
What a battle. He'll go down dying.
Garth Butcher is the other defenseman who haven't scored. They have gone combined 138 games with no goals. But they could play for me any day if they never score. Butcher and Snap, two tough cookies.
Harold Snap remains on as Gilmore goes around the goal to pass it back to McGinnis again. He and Suter go at it. Mullen, back of the net. Again, the setup play. Mullen got in front, but now Gilmore back to Suter. Shot. He can't deflect it. Snap saved another one. Snap rocked it away from the goal line. Saving a goal again tonight. Now Sutter brings it out for Vancouver. Gets up as far as the Calgary line. McGinnis stops him. Suter takes it. 25 seconds left on the penalty. Here's Mullen, just missed the pass, breaking in around Butcher. Bent over on the boards, we're into the final minute of the period. 15 seconds left on the power play for Calgary. Newendyke slapped at it, and it'll be cleared down the ice with only 5 seconds left on the penalty. Bozak ready to step back on. He's on now, penalty is over. Flames lead by three. Passed in by Reinhardt, he has to hurry though. Got in there in time. Just in time to touch it. And icing called against the Calgary Flames.
Stan Smeal will talk to Scott Oak at the end of this period. Stan Smeal, the captain, the most experienced Vancouver Canuck. He's played the most games of any one player in Canuck history. You know, Bob, he's not taking an easy stride in one of them.
I bet. Snaps getting a well-deserved rest. He was on for quite a while killing the penalty. Hung on with about 20 seconds left of the penalty. Then he had to go.
And there's another old-timer, Mel Bridgman. He's the most experienced playoff hockey player for the Vancouver Canucks, playing a lot of games with Philadelphia, Calgary, Detroit, and others.
On the faceoff, Bridgman battles for it in the corner. It's cleared by McCown to Gilmore and down the ice again. And Calgary just trying to run out the clock now. But Crimmin and Bridgman in a lock and behind the play. I think he might send him off. With 20 seconds left, they'll go to the dressing rooms, if, in fact, they are penalized. They weren't doing very much.
Well, let's have a look at McCrimmon. He goes into the corner with Bridgman. The puck comes out of there. McCrimmon, I don't know whether he knows whether the puck's out or not. Hulk Hogan never had as many good holds as that one in WrestleMania last week. And it's just a question of time before McCrimmon, the old sergeant, gets a little upset with that headlock.
No penalties. That was just too minor for anything. 20 seconds left of the period. And the Flames will take this big lead into the second intermission as McCrimmon shoots it in. Reinhardt back. Patterson going in after it. 5 seconds to play in the period. They hold it in the corner this time, and the horn goes to end period number two.
Garth Butcher and Colin Patterson were wrestling while Gilmore was being pinned against the boards, and all this developed. And there you can see the referee turning and warning the teams that they don't want anybody coming off the bench as the period is over, or they'll get that sentence, 10-game suspension for leaving the bench.
Quite a pile of players, they'll just peel them off. I think they've settled it down. Fleury at 3:20. Gilmore on a power play at 12:25 to make it 4-0. Adams got Vancouver's only goal at 15:56. And that's it. After period two, the score at the end of the second period. Calgary Flames 4, the Vancouver Canucks 1.
.107 Kick FM and rock and roll. We've grown up together. .107 Kick FM with the greatest.
The Beatles.
Been a hard day's night. And the latest. The widest variety of music with less repetition so you can listen longer. 107 Kick FM, Calgary's classic rock.
When the feeling's right, you know it, we're there for you.
Oh, flowers fresh, the perfect joy is always there for you.
Together, a special touch, sure to please. Together,
part of your family.
I know it's the weekend, but I need those figures. We gotta find Brian.
Yeah, really.
Hello, Ben. How are you?
You bet. Do you have a modem on your computer?
Sure do.
No problem, Ben. I'll get them off to you right away. Bye bye.
Our figure.
Aye.
Where's Longview?
AGT, Advanced Global Telecommunications.
When you're taking aim at tough broadleaf weeds, you can use a cheap herbicide and miss the weeds, or an expensive one that misses Canada thistle, or you can use Target. For last year's low price of $3.50 an acre, Target controls cowcockle, smartweed, wild buckwheat, and for a little more, Canada thistle. Get tough control at a tough-to-beat price. Get on Target.
You won't believe it. A wild oat and broadleaf herbicide that's gentle on wheat and barley, but tough on wild oats. A wild oat herbicide that works under normal or dry conditions. A wild oat herbicide that alone controls broadleaf weeds and is tank mixable with 2,4-D ester and MCPA ester. A wild oat herbicide with an early 1-4 leaf application window. Assert. You won't believe it until you try it.
Champion Sandy Lyle and the world's best golfers go for the green jacket at the Masters Saturday on CBC.
CBC News with Don Goodwin.
Here are tonight's top stories. George Bush gives qualified support in Washington to Israeli Prime Minister Yitzhak Shamir's call for elections among Palestinian Arabs in the occupied territories. Prime Minister Mulroney says Canada's constitution is virtually worthless because of the notwithstanding clause. The Canadian Human Rights Commission says Canada is falling far short of wiping out discrimination, and it criticizes Ottawa for hiring too few natives and minorities and for leaving too many women in low-paid jobs. A leaked report says Transport Department officials warned years ago they didn't have the manpower or money to make sure air travel was safe. And at a state dinner in London tonight, Mikhail Gorbachev's reform policies are hailed by Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher as the beginning of a peaceful revolution. Tomorrow he lunches with the Queen. More news after the game. Now back to Hockey Night in Canada.
Welcome back to the Stanley Cup Playoffs 1989. An update from St. Louis for you. For the second straight night, the Blues and North Stars went into overtime, and for the second straight night, the North Stars won it, this time on Rick Mahar's goal, just over 5 minutes and 30 seconds in, and so St. Louis leads that Norris Division Series 2-0. Here at the Olympic Saddle Dome, it's 4-1 Calgary over Vancouver after two periods of play. Greg G. Adams has the only goal for the Canucks, but Stan Smeal might have thought he scored before Adams did in the second period, although Mike Vernon got over to make one of those one-in-a-million saves. You didn't argue that much about it.
No, I did not. He made the save. He came back into play. Actually, I did not see him, that he was still out of the net. I had time. I should have taken a look, but I went on my backhand. I rushed myself on that play. I could have went my forehand, and I went to the far side, and he was right there. The other thing, too, I could have shot along the ice, and it would have made it a lot harder for him to pick it up with his glove.
Did anyone deserve to revel in last night's upset win by the Vancouver Canucks more than Stan Smeal did? I should think not. You were there for the Canucks Stanley Cup final appearance in 1982, but also there for the nightmarish long seasons that followed. You appreciate fully what last night's win meant.
Definitely. I think... there's two things. The win last night and getting into the playoffs, you know, a lot of people counted us out, and we worked hard to get into playoffs. And to start our playoffs like we did last night, we played our game. And we had Calgary playing our game, and to come up in the overtime and winning, it was a great accomplishment by all of us, but we're not over with this series yet.
A lot harder to get the Flames to play your game tonight.
Definitely. I think they haven't played us for a long time, and they heard a lot of things, probably a lot of scouting reports, just like us. But we went out and played our game, and they were a little hesitant on their own game. And tonight you saw in the first period, they came at us pretty good. They forechecked, and that is their game. And how we got to stop them is we got to hold them up. We got to grab them, hold them up in that neutral zone, and not let them get in forechecking on us.
Well, they're excited over you in Vancouver, and I should think it's nice to be recognized there for positive reasons for a change.
Definitely, yeah. You know, that we've gone through some bad times, and now we're just looking ahead. And I think the people of Vancouver deserve it, along with the owners. And you know, it's just a number of things, and it's build up. It's a hockey town, and they appreciate it. And we've come hard and worked hard this whole season. And that's what's been nice with us. There hasn't been a game over the 80 games where we haven't worked hard to get what we wanted to get.
Stan, regardless of what happens as far as the final result is concerned tonight, you're going to leave the city of Calgary with a split on Flames ice, and that's the goal of any road team to start the playoffs.
Definitely. Whenever you start, you want to upset them maybe the first or second game. You want to get one. You got to get one to get that home ice advantage. And we got that one, and now, you know, we got a goal, and now we're coming on. We're starting to create things like we did before, and you know, a couple more bounces here and a couple shots on net, you never know what's going to happen.
Thank you, Stan. It's no longer a sentence for you to play hockey in Vancouver. It's a delight, and you deserve it.
Great, thank you.
Live on CBC, this is Molson Hockey Night in Canada.